Today on Gage Boys Garage, we're going to make a doubler out of two 231 Jeep transfer cases.
So I bought this kit online, and it is an np231 doubler kit. Now this allows you to take the front planetary set of one 231 and put it in front of your stock np231 transfer case, and this will give you double low. So you can either have your single low, factory low, 272:1, or you can have your double low, which is like 7.4:1, I believe. And so you get this plate and clock ring, and you get this shaft here to adapt it to the front of another T case. And basically this, you're gonna set in here and you're gonna cut this ear off your T case. Now this was from Frolich Suspensions, I believe. I'll link it in the description of the video. But I just popped my 231 T case apart, and the only thing I've done is move this ship fork over here, and I put the supplied shaft into here to get everything kind of lined up. Now my kit didn't come with any instructions, so I'm just kind of winging it. So, right?
Yeah.
No instructions. So it looks like this shaft is going to have to be cut down to fit this new plate. As you can see, it sticks up way too high. And I'm going to have to take that second shift fork off, because this shift fork is for your four-wheel drive shifter, and that doesn't matter on this first case. And that shaft has a little spot in this piece here.
Oh, yeah, it's got to locate
in. Yep, to locate into. So it looks like the shaft's gonna have to be cut about 1/4 inch above the surface of this case. And then when we stick this on, we will cut basically at that seam in the case. And this end cap here will need to be welded onto the case. Like that. It'll be welded in here. And
yeah, check it out.
It'll delete the four-wheel drive side of your T-case that you no longer need. So I'm going to get going on this. And so just a little update. My pin refused to come out. So I just took a little tiny drill bit, knocked a punch in the middle, ran that little one through. Then I ran this drill bit through, a little bit bigger. And now tapped it with the hammer, slides right out. So now we have our pin, and that's gonna locate our low shift fork, low to high shift fork, I guess. That's gonna sit in there like that. And then, as you can see, that sticks up above the case here a bit. So we're gonna have to cut it down, but we wanna leave it a little bit long so that it sits in this pocket on the new front cover here. You know, this is gonna sit in like that to keep this from moving around when you're shifting. So, as you can see, I trimmed this down. All I did was I set this on here as a straight edge, and I cut it just above the bottom, probably 1/8 inch up. And then I took this top piece, I set it on here like that, and I tightened these up just by hand, and I drew a line on the case where I need to trim off. So in the end, you'll be left with something that looks like, you know, that. and that'll be your doubler. So I'm gonna probably start with a sawzall and try and cut this and just see how that goes. So now I started disassembling the case. I pulled the pin out, I pulled the shifter out. This all just pulls right out, and I'm setting it here on the bench. Now I'm pulling. I took the bolts out of this here, and then I came in right here and popped this up to break the seal. And then under here, there's a little snap ring. Right here, this smaller one around the input shaft. We're gonna have to pop that off to allow your planetary set to come out, because you don't really wanna be cutting this off and welding while the planetary set's in there. You could get away with it, but it's not worth it. And I wanna clean this case up. So I'm gonna pop that out quick. And so I got the snap ring off. Took a little bit of dicking around, but we got it. Then come over here. As you can see, it's not on there anymore. So flip the case, hard to grab this with one hand. Pull it straight up and out. That's your planetary gear set. Now, as you can see, this is a 3-gear. I wish it was a 6-gear planetary, but can't always get what we want, I guess. So I just got done power washed this case up. It's not perfect, obviously. It's a probably 25, 30 year old case because this is from a YJ. Anyway, but yeah, it's a lot better than it was. So now I am gonna go to a buddy's house, and you could do this with a spool gun MIG, but I don't have the skills to do it. So I think he's gonna aluminum MIG the plate in here to keep it sealing. I have heard of people just JB welding this, and it probably lasts for a little while, but that's not really what I want. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of extra time and have this welded up, and then I don't have to worry about it anymore. So yeah. So this is where I'm at with the doubler right now. I had a friend weld this plate on here, did a really good job. And I threw all the guts back in, and I threw the shaft that came with the kit in there. And I threw the bolts in just to, you know, kind of test, make sure everything's happy. And I'm pretty happy with how this thing's coming out. So as you can see, I have the 231 case out of my Jeep Cherokee. This has a slip yoke eliminator kit and a 1350 yoke on the back, but the front is stock 1310, same yoke as every other Cherokee. Anyway, I am starting to put the adapter plate onto the second case, or the, you know, the factory case. And I notice I have all 5 of these bolts in, and this 6th bolt does not line up with the case, which I find very weird. I'm not sure if that's just a manufacturing defect, or if there's different, like there's a reason for this bolt being off. I'm not sure, but for my case, the plate does not line up perfectly. So I think I'm just gonna run 5 bolts at the moment. I'm still thinking about this, but we'll see. So I'm gonna just continue getting the adapter together and get the two cases mated together. So I have the 2 cases loosely mated up, and I just want to show you guys the gear reduction we have now. So this is, you know, this will be the input coming from your transmission, and that'll be your rear drive shaft. So, as you can see, I'm spinning this a bunch, and the yoke back there is barely moving. Well, if you're by yourself and you can't lift your super heavy transfer case into place, I used my floor jack because I don't have a trans jack to get it as high as I could. And I ran two ratchet straps from either side of the Jeep to cradle it and get it just the rest of the way up there. And now I can kind of maneuver it and line it up to the transmission by myself. So I'm under the Jeep, and I've been working on my crossmember new mount. So it's in the factory location still, but the factory mounts are pretty shitty. There's a lot of problems with them. I've had to replace this one twice already. So I had an old motor mount kit thing, and I welded it to the factory top plate. And then I welded some ears onto my crossmember, and that's going to be a lot sturdier transmission support just because of the added weight of all this. And I've wanted to do this for a while, so it seemed like a good opportunity to do so. So yeah, that's just an update on what I'm doing. As you can see, there's room all around this transfer case in this tunnel. On the Jeep Cherokee XJ, it fits right in here. I didn't have to modify the floor at all, luckily. So just an update, I got the T-cases in. I think you guys have seen that. And now I had to cut a huge hole in my four-link crossmember because I'm rear coil on this Jeep Cherokee. And I'm just bracing it back up so that it doesn't fold in half now that I cut all of its support out. So, been doing a little bit of work, got my drive shafts in, stuff like that. This is actually my rear drive shaft from the Jeep. Well, with my Sterling 10.5, and it fit in the front pretty well. It's a little short, but for testing purposes, it'll be fine. And then up here, you can see I have a terrible linkage for my rear case, but it seems to be working. I made it out a quarter inch, so hopefully it doesn't flex or bend, but it has to go over the front case, but then down far enough to meet the rear case. So it took a little bit of messing around, but it seems to be working. I might revise it later. And then for my front case,
I extended the arm so that it's easier to move, and then I ran it up through the floor. So I'll show you what that looks like in the Jeep. So in the Jeep, we have our factory shifter for the rear case, your actual four-wheel drive case. And then I put a little sprocket on here as like a little knob for my double low case. So I have my factory, you know, four high, neutral, low. So I can throw this in low, and then this is high, and that's low. All you got to do, move it up and down. Neutral is in the middle on the front case here, but you're never going to be using neutral anyway. So yeah, if you want low, you go here. If you want double low, you got double low. Then if you want too low, you can be in two high, low. So then you have single low and two. It's pretty cool. Or if you wanted four low, technically you could go into four high here. Then you have four low. So it gives you a lot more options. So just a little update. I got pretty much everything done that I'm doing today. I got all the cross members back in, front rear drive shaft, made a new exhaust, and I'm gonna show you guys the low gearing right now. And it's absolutely ridiculous.
So this is low gear.